The 7900 XTX is a super powerful GPU.
Phenomenal cosmic power!
I ran Beat Saber on it at 4704 by 2384 at 120 Hz with all the game settings maxed out, and it didn't even break a sweat. I tried it with Vader Immortal, same thing. I then tried Contractors. It crushed it. Pavlov crushed it too. In fact, it ran every game I tested really well. But there were some things I noticed in the headset in some of the games I tested that don't show up in these captures or even on the performance graphs. The most annoying thing I experienced while doing my testing was stuttering. Unfortunately, you can't really see it in these captures, but one of the games I experienced this problem in was The Walking Dead: Saints and Sinners. When you look at the frame rate and performance headroom graphs, the 7900 XTX crushed it, but as I would move around, I experienced a fair amount of stuttering. To add a little insult to injury, there were also moments here and there where I experienced some brief performance hiccups. To be fair, this is normal behavior for this game, though. I've experienced these same hiccups while testing with other GPUs. I don't know why exactly they happen, but occasionally the performance headroom will spike, and the frame rate will drop down momentarily, and then come right back. This happens almost every time you fight a walker, but you'll also see it when there doesn't really seem to be a reason for it to happen. Another little oddity I ran into was in Vader Immortal. There was these weird artifacts in the background in this scene. It didn't affect the gameplay at all, but it was kind of distracting. While I was messing around with settings in Contractors and Pavlov, I found this glitch is tied to anti-aliasing. If I turn the anti-aliasing up past a certain point, these artifacts would appear. To solve this problem in those games, I just kept anti-aliasing at a lower setting, but Vader Immortal doesn't give you the option to turn it down, so there wasn't really anything I could do about it there. At the time I'm making this video, AMD does acknowledge that performance in some VR games is not as good as it should be with their 7000 series GPUs, and they promise to fix these issues in future driver updates. So hopefully these will be resolved in the not too distant future. If these were the only issues I encountered, ones that can be potentially fixed through a driver update, that would bode pretty well for AMD, but for my testing, I'm using an Oculus Quest 2, and this highlighted a weakness in AMD's hardware they've actually had for a while. I didn't notice it in some of my past reviews, like with the 6700 XT and the 6950 XT, because I wasn't looking for it, but this time around, I was looking. And I saw it. AMD's H.264 video encoder is noticeably worse than Nvidia's. By saying this, I'm not saying AMD's is bad, I'm just saying Nvidia's is better. Using my Quest 2, even with a link cable, while the graphics looked good with the 7900 XTX, since I have Nvidia GPUs to directly compare it to, I could easily tell the visuals were softer looking. The transcoded video streams on my Nvidia GPUs look sharp and crisp, and the graphics with the 7900 XTX were just a little soft. This is only a problem for me though, because I'm using the Quest 2, which does not use HDMI or DisplayPort. For people using a Valve Index or Reverb G2 or some other headset, this will not affect you. It's not all bad news for AMD though when using a Quest 2. While the Oculus software doesn't support H.265 encoding, Virtual Desktop does. And using H.265, this sharpened the visuals right up on par with what I'm used to seeing with my Nvidia GPUs. The downside is you do have to purchase Virtual Desktop to be able to enjoy this. For my reviews though, I prefer being able to see the performance graphs provided with the Oculus debug tool. And since the graphics still looked good using H.264, I did all my testing using Oculus Link on my Ryzen 7 5800 X3D test PC with 32 gigabytes of DDR4 3600 MHz CL16 RAM, and our GPU is the PowerColor RX 7900 XTX Red Devil. The game where I feel the 7900 XTX flexed its muscles the most was in Red Matter 2. In most areas of the game, it ran at 120 FPS with all the game settings set to their maximum. Yes, it ran this game at 120 FPS, and the in-game resolution scale was set to 2.0. Just to give you guys a point of reference, the RTX 4080 ran this game at the same resolution and refresh rate, but the resolution scale was only at 1.3. Again, this is the performance I saw in most areas of the game. But when I went to my two stress test areas, they turned out to be just a little bit more taxing on the GPU than it could handle. And our performance headroom dropped into the negative, and the compositor dropped our frame rate in half to keep things feeling smooth. I then lowered the render scale to 1.9, and that was just enough to keep the performance headroom above zero here, but when I moved on to my laser scanning tool test on the window, that pushed us over the edge once again. While this was all really exciting, Red Matter 2 is another game where I experienced stuttering when moving around. Hopefully AMD can eliminate this stuttering with a future driver update, because performance-wise, this was a very impressive result for the 7900XTX. For all you sim racers out there, I tested the 7900XTX with Assetto Corsa, and you'll be happy to know it was able to run this game at 120 FPS with all the game settings maxed out, except for anti-aliasing, at 4704 by 2384. Performance headroom was really close to the edge at 120Hz, so I'd probably recommend 90Hz rather than 120 just to make sure you're good. But these tests are about pushing the GPU as far as it'll go, so that's what we do. Lone Echo 2 is another game I would recommend running at 90Hz rather than 120Hz, but to see what the 7900XTX could do, I ran all my tests in this game at 120Hz. In most areas of the game, it ran at or very near 120 FPS with the game settings pretty well maxed out. As you can see on the performance graphs, the settings I used are just a little bit higher than the 7900XTX can consistently maintain. Most of the time, performance dips were brief enough, it didn't affect the experience. However, when I got to this, I guess I'll call it a cutscene segment, the framerate fluctuations made the game feel a bit choppy. So while the 7900XTX can run this game pretty well at 120Hz, you get a much more enjoyable experience at 90Hz.
Shoving you in an anomaly and hoping it all works out.
The only game I did not try running at 120Hz with the 7900XTX is Microsoft Flight Simulator. This game is just so freaking beastly. I did try it at 90Hz though, at 4704 by 2384. My standard settings for running this game, so I can get a good apples-to-apples comparison with other GPUs I test, is to set the render scaling, world scale, terrain level of detail, and objects level of detail to 100, and all the other settings to their lowest values. The only other GPU I've tested that's been able to run this game at or near 90 FPS is the RTX 4080, and even it wasn't able to maintain a frame rate this solid. Look at that FPS graph, almost no fluctuation whatsoever. This training flight is of course not exactly the most demanding scenario this game has to offer though, so I switched locations to New York City, and as expected, the compositor had to cut the frame rate in half to keep things feeling somewhat smooth. While that may seem like a less than desirable result to those not familiar with running Flight Simulator in VR, all the VR pilots out there know this is actually a very respectable result. While the frame rate is low, the fact that Flight Simulator is a slow-paced game keeps things feeling smooth enough that the overall experience is enjoyable. When I first fired up Half-Life Alyx at 120Hz, things were pretty choppy. This wasn't just the driver-related stuttering issue I experienced in some of the other games though, as the performance we were experiencing is being reflected on the graphs. Sometimes things get weird like this when switching from one game to another, and the PC just needs to be rebooted, so I did that, thinking that may resolve the issue, but upon starting the game up the second time at 120Hz, it was still choppy, just like it was before. I tried turning the settings down from ultra to high, but that made almost no difference at all. I then tried switching the API from DirectX 11 to Vulkan, but that actually made things even worse. In the end, I dropped the refresh rate from 120Hz to 90Hz, and that made all the difference. When I went back and compared it to the 6950 XT, though, I found the performance in this game to be lacking quite a bit. As of the making of this video, the 6950 XT outperforms the 7900 XTX in this game. It would seem Half-Life Alyx is one of those VR games AMD says their 7000 series GPUs performs worse in than it should. I should also mention I did notice a little bit of the stuttering in this game as well. Hopefully, AMD will have a driver update in the not too distant future that will unlock the 7900 XTX's full potential in this game, as well as fix the stuttering problem. Going into this, I knew AMD's drivers for the 7900 XTX still needed some work, so I wasn't expecting things to be perfect. I actually thought I was going to run into a lot more problems than I did, so overall, I was impressed with the way the 7900 XTX performed, and I'm excited to see what kind of improvements future driver updates will bring. For anyone running a Quest 2 though, or other headset that relies on a transcoded video stream to play PC VR, I do have some reservations when it comes to recommending the 7900 XTX, simply because Nvidia's H.264 encoder produces a noticeably sharper image. If this isn't something that's going to affect you though, I feel the 7900 XTX could be a very nice alternative to Nvidia's ridiculously priced RTX 4080. Assuming AMD gets their drivers dialed in and working properly, of course. Subscribe!